Vice President Leni Robredo is bringing back her office's so-called swab cabs, or roving buses that offer COVID-19 tests. That's amid the limited number of testing at the moment. Robredo also announced on Twitter that her office's free teleconsultation platform, Bayanihan e-Consulta, is also open for anyone needing the advice of doctors. Metro Manila to impose mobility restrictions on the unvaccinated in light of the latest COVID-19 surge in the Philippines. Metropolitan Manila Development Authority Chairman Benher Abalos says mayors have agreed to pass local ordinances that will bar unvaccinated people from making non-essential trips.
Para kang nag-ECQ only for the unvaccinated. No, for their own protection. Dapat nasa bahay lang sila, pwede sila lumabas kung bibili na sila ng essential goods and services.
Abalos says this policy will only take effect while Metro Manila is under the stricter Alert Level 3. He adds mayors are still finalizing the restrictions.
There is an urgent need for the Metro Manila local governments to enact the respective on the enhanced restrictions on vaccinations to regulate the mobility of the unvaccinated individuals in the NCR. Ito'y inaayos lamang namin subject to form and style. Kaya lamang namin ito'y nilalabas ngayon, no, para lamang mai-announce kaagad at mapaghandaan ng bawat isa.
Metro Manila will remain under Alert Level 3 until January 15th.
The Interior Department orders random inspections of quarantine hotels in the wake of breaches of health protocols. The police have been tapped to help monitor at least 150 accredited hotels that serve as quarantine facilities for incoming travelers.
Kung wala po yung tao doon, ay kaagad-agad pong iimbestigahan at sasampahan po ng kaso yung hotel at yung individual na skip quarantine at lahat po ng mga tao na may kinalaman sa ganung modus operandi.
The stricter monitoring comes amid backlash from the case of a Filipina who arrived from the U.S. and slipped out of quarantine to attend a party. The woman, Gwyneth Chua, later tested COVID positive along with seven of her close contacts. The Tourism Department on Monday revealed another Filipino was caught skipping quarantine. The person was caught after going out for a massage and posting photos of it on social media. Violators of COVID-19 health protocols in the Philippines face a fine of up to 50,000 pesos or imprisonment of up to 6 months. Malacanang vows to take tougher actions on violators.
The Philippines again classified as high risk for COVID-19. Health Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere points out new infections in the Philippines have increased significantly in recent days, most especially in the National Capital Region. It is not yet confirmed whether the rise in cases is due to the more infectious Omicron variant, but the DOH and other experts already assume that it is.
Na andyan na siya sa community because we have seen the sudden increase in the number of cases. Now for us to declare or to be able to determine if there is local transmission, kailangan pa rin po natin ng definitive, no, or confirmatory test from the whole genome sequencing or the Philippine Genome Center so that we'll be able to really say na talagang Omicron yung mga kaso.
We know it's Omicron because there's anecdotal stories now that many of the COVID patients over the last week experienced severe sore throat. And this is not something we saw with Delta. So if some people actually lose their voice for a couple of days, this sore throat is an Omicron signature.
So far, the Philippines has 14 confirmed cases of the Omicron variant. Health Undersecretary Leopoldo Vega warns it could become the dominant strain in the Philippines within a month. But even so, the Okta Research Group believes an Omicron wave should pose less of a challenge than the previous Delta-driven surge.
I would prefer this to be an Omicron wave because the percentage of hospitalizations is significantly lower with Omicron. If you look at the data from South Africa, there are fewer people in the hospital who need oxygen, fewer people who need mechanical ventilation, which is good news And yet, if you're unvaccinated, the risk for both of them is significantly higher. Hopefully, it will be a relatively brief wave. It will only hopefully only last, like in South Africa, for a month rather than for 2 months.
The Philippines logged 4,084 more COVID infections Monday. The number of active cases now nearing 25,000. 21 labs were not able to submit data. The health department reported a 20.7% positivity rate, the highest since September 30th. But ABS-CBN News' data analytics head pegs the figure to be higher at 26.6%, which means that more than one out of four people tested is turning out positive for the coronavirus.
Hospital admissions in Metro Manila are rising as COVID-19 cases spike in the country. Data from the health department also show a steady increase in the occupancy rate of ICU beds in the capital region. St. Luke's Medical Center describes the increase in patient confinement concerning. It adds a number of its healthcare workers are also showing COVID-19 symptoms.
Nag-increase ang consultation sa emergency room by about 200 to 250%. And 80% noong nagpupunta sa co-consult sa emergency room are COVID-related. Ang isang nakakabahala, because pagka ganyan dumadami ang kaso, we are beginning to monitor our healthcare workers. Bigla rin tumaas. Kaya sisimulan namin yung mass screening, especially those who are assigned sa high volume areas like the emergency room and the ICUs, as well as in those wards who are admitting patients with COVID diagnosis.